Recently, I've started live streaming on my TikTok, where I do real-time edit with me sessions. During these, I've frequently been asked, how do you come up with creative transitions? I tried my best to explain, but I realized that it would require a much more thought through and in-depth answer. So here's my video explaining how I come up with creative transitions such as this, this, and this. This video isn't about making the transitions, it's about coming up with the ideas. Additionally, I'm going to be doing a challenge where I document every time I come up with a transition idea whilst going about my everyday life. And there will be a surprise built up throughout the video and revealed at the end, so keep watching. Albert Einstein once said, "Creativity is seeing what others see and thinking what no one else ever thought." Creativity is all around us, or at least the beginning of creativity is. It's our job to carry out the task of creativity. This doesn't require some hyperactive imagination or a movie-like protagonist drive. It simply requires us to adapt how we see things in our everyday life, considering even the most mundane objects, not just as things to spectate and move on from, but things to interact with. Things that serve a purpose. Many of us go through life not considering objects around us. Me personally, when I walk around and my eyes are everywhere all at once, without even noticing. In one second I'm seeing the ground, the grass, houses, trees, the world around us. It's often viewed through a trance-like state, or what we call zoning out. You are not immune to creativity. In fact, it's quite the opposite. Have you ever lay in bed late at night, thinking of an extravagant plotline? Have you ever considered different scenarios of your favourite characters? Likely yes. You may be thinking, how does this relate to editing? Well, you were able to take something you saw and create a story about it, likely without even realising how much creativity that takes. I'm suggesting you can adapt this to your editing. Look at the world around you. What do you see? You see your phone? Couldn't that be a phone transition? Even the air in front of us? What if it suddenly became solid? What if the floor dropped out beneath us? What if, what if, what if? Asking this question, what if, is something actively discouraged. However, I believe it's the very first step to creativity. You then ignore the water stain. And I thought, what if there was a projection up here? It can be hard to do this first method, especially on a whim. It's a big difference between walking outside, seeing the world around you,
because I just gone and wrote on my hand for this video,
having your imagination naturally come up with ideas, versus sitting staring at a blank editing screen. So thankfully, there is another way. This way is much more commonly used by editors like Lauren, Anna, Naughty Juan, and myself. It's using lyrics as a guideline on what to do next. You could even go to an extension and say this method is used by artists such as Billie Eilish.
I tried to scream, but my head was underwater.
Sabrina Carpenter. And Lana Del Rey. Music triggers something creative in our brain, and it's often overlooked in editing. We focus on the smoothness of the velocity or the complexity of the transition, and don't think about the fact we're often using a world-renowned artist's creation. Our edit isn't the only art piece in the edit. The music is, and when done right, they should complement each other seamlessly to tell a story. This brings me to the final part of this video, what I just mentioned. Storytelling. You see, what we as editors often don't realise is that we have the power to make our daydreams tangible. We have the power to think of absolutely anything and create it, actualise it. After all, editing is an art, an expression of our thoughts. Personally, I cannot think of a transition idea if it's not somehow expressing a thought, emotion, or idea from me. I can't make my edits 100% about Sabrina. They contain pieces of me, like a diary I document. So what's going on in your life? What stories have you built up in your head through maladaptive daydreaming? You have the power to share it with the world at your fingertips. Take advantage of it. I can't do that because my app isn't that advanced.
Yes, he can!
When it comes to creativity, there is no limitation. As long as you have your imagination, it's all you need. I know this will be taken with a grain of salt, as I'm an After Effects editor, and everyone knows After Effects is expensive, and not exactly accessible to everyone. So, I've decided to create the most creative transition edit I can, on CapCut, for free, to prove that creativity doesn't come with buying a software. And the transitions and techniques that I've been showing throughout this video have actually all been leading up to this edit. I'd like to point out I haven't used CapCut to make edits in years, so I might be a little rusty. But without further ado, I present to you the final product.